This problem demonstrates first how to find an equation for a velocity given two velocities at two separate points, and then from that velocity, determining the local acceleration, the convective acceleration, and then the acceleration of the particular fluid at two different points. So we have V1 equaling 10 meters per second at x equals 0, and V2 equaling 25 meters per second at x2 equals 1 meter. So the fact that the velocity changes from point 1 to point 2 tells us there must be some kind of acceleration. So the problem says that it is a linear fashion. So what we're going to try and do is write our velocity in such that u equals ax plus b. There's no velocity in the y direction. There's no velocity in the z direction. So our acceleration is going to equal du dt plus u du dx. This is our local acceleration. And one thing that you can see is that u is not a function of time. The other part is our convective acceleration, and that's what we're going to try to find. So u equals 10 meters per second at x equals 0. So that means 10 equals 0 ax is 0 plus b. It also equals 25 meters per second at x equals 1. So 25, which is u, equals 1 times a, since x is 1, plus b. Two equations, two unknowns. Therefore, a equals 15, b equals 10. And we can rewrite our velocity as 15x plus 10 meters per second. So our ax equals u, which is 15x plus 10, times du dx, which is just 15. And so our acceleration is 225x plus 150 meters per second squared. And again, you can see that when you look at u, there is no dependence on time. So the local acceleration is 0. So at x equals 0, we substitute x equals 0 into our acceleration. Our acceleration is going to equal 150 meters per second squared. At x equals 1, we substitute 1 into our acceleration. A equals 375 meters per second squared.